When you look at the millennials who say they're not going to vote this November in the 2014 midterm elections, one of the reasons why is that they don't like either of the two major political parties. If you're not a Democrat and you're not a Republican, where do you go?
There's another aspect of big government that has attracted attention in the media, specifically in relation to millennials, and that's the surveillance state. National security, foreign policy, to the extent that the Obama administration has continued Bush policies, the president's been a real disappointment to younger voters, many of whom were some of his most ardent supporters. What have you found about the way that the government's behavior on those kinds of issues have affected changing millennial attitudes?
Millennials don't trust government agencies to do the right thing. In fact, 58% said that they thought government agencies generally abuse their power. Generally is the word here, and that's really key. This isn't occasionally or once in a while, but generally. And another thing that we asked was about trust in political parties. Fully 50% of millennials said they trusted neither Democrats or Republicans when it came to privacy. And part of the reason is that both parties haven't really staked different positions on these issues. They really, if you disagree with the status quo, you don't really have an alternative to turn to.
So when you're looking at someone like Edward Snowden, who, you know, the caricature of millennials is, well, he was kind of a celebrity and they just latched onto him personally. He was young, they could identify with him, he was standing up to the man. But there's something more conceptually sophisticated going on here, right?
Absolutely. The Pew Research Center has done some very interesting work on this, showing that young people are the only cohort to say that what he did was the right thing. To say that that they disagree with the government surveillance programs that are going on right now. And we have to think about how these young people grew up. Millennials grew up in a world of fast-paced technological change, where they become accustomed to having lots of choices, being able to personalize things, and they have really come to respect their individual autonomy. And when government is perhaps snooping on your personal interactions, that really bothers this cohort in ways that if you talk about government taxing the wealthy or taxing you too much, although they may care, if the government is listening to their phone calls, they're going to care a lot more about that than they will about high taxes at this point in their lives.
So it turns out that they might actually be more interested in political freedom, actual liberty, and not just personal freedom as that's usually thought of. But
yeah.
Is there any evidence that, that they're interested in going to the next step, which is then getting more involved in the practice of politics, not just turning out in droves when the right kind of candidate comes along in November, but actually involving themselves in political activity?
That's a very important and interesting question, and it's hard to answer. We did see a spike in interest in 2008. It declined in 2012. And when you look at the millennials who say they're not going to vote this November in the 2014 midterm elections, one of the reasons why is that they don't like either of the two major political parties. If you're not a Democrat and you're not a Republican, where do you go? Who do you vote for? Well, you may as well just stay home, is what a lot of people conclude. In fact, we presented them with a non-traditional candidate to see how they would react. We asked them if they would support a candidate who was both socially liberal and fiscally conservative. But what did they say? 53% said they would support such a candidate. And the liberal millennials were actually the most supportive than the conservatives.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Does that seem to you to indicate a trend where in even just 5 years, those numbers are going to be even more dramatically shifting?
Perhaps. I think that what we see right now, millennials are largely basing their political judgments on social issues, social tolerance, choice and acceptance. Those are the things that they really care about. But over the next few years, when economics become more salient to their lives, we may see some shifts. I mean, we see that liberals are more interested in a socially liberal, fiscally conservative candidate. That means that perhaps they would be open to a fiscally conservative candidate. We may see some changes on the left. On the right, we're also seeing a trend towards social liberalism as well. A majority of young Republicans say that they think gay couples should be allowed to get married. This is significant. This is different than older Republicans.